This is ABC 7 News, Chicago's number one news, with Cheryl Burton, Ron Majors, weather with meteorologist Jerry Taft, and sports with Marchie and Greco. This is ABC 7 News at 5.
A two-part, made-for-television movie is set to air next month about the terrorists behind the September 11th attacks and the steps leading up to that day almost 5 years ago. Today, a conference of law enforcement officers previewed the movie. ABC 7's Leah Hope has more.
Amid the new gadgets and gear for law enforcement officials, attendees of the Midwest Security and Police Conference also got a special screening of a new miniseries about 9/11. The Path to 9/11 is a two-part series that will air on ABC in September. It is a dramatization based on the 9/11 Commission report. Today, those in law enforcement reflected on the events of 9/11 and changes since. Within this law enforcement community, there is a shift in communication and an emphasis on sharing information with one another.
We have become much more aware of the need to openly share information with state, county, and federal authorities as much as they with us.
Chicago's special agent in charge of the FBI says sharing goes beyond law enforcement and requires a better relationship with the community.
It's not just a police responsibility, it's also a local political responsibility to know their communities, understand their communities, and be sensitive to the things around the world that may affect them that may not affect the rest of us.
The Council on American-Islamic Relations has been involved with some of the community meetings with the FBI. Despite efforts to build relations and educate, the backlash from 9/11 continues to hurt some Muslims in our community, they say.
We're looking at employment discrimination. We're looking at policies, sometimes that are sanctioned, detentions, deportations.
The council, known as CARE for short, currently represents more than 400 Chicagoans who claim discrimination since 9/11. Hina Mustafji became a lawyer after 9/11 and started wearing a hijab head covering.
To be pointed out and stopped and asked, you know, why are your people creating this havoc? Why are your people killing, you know, Americans? And I'm like, they're not my people. You are my people.
Mustafji used to live in New York and lost three close friends in the World Trade Center attacks. She had hoped more would be learned after 9/11.
No one from CARE has seen previews of the miniseries, but the group hopes the miniseries, as well as an upcoming feature film about 9/11, will include the Muslim Americans who were also killed in the World Trade Center. In the newsroom, Leah Hope, ABC 7 News. Cheryl?
All right, Leah, thank you for that report.